here. I have been somewhat sidetracked by other things, but also still kind of thrown off by the strange things happening with this pit. Have the Commodore 16 here, which is still a mystery. It's funny, you know, when you go into electronics store, you sort of have an idea that the people there might know a little bit about electronics. How crazy is that? A 1701 monitor makes a great place to put things. I know I've been experimenting with some tape drives, but I really should have written things on them. Oh, Bill. Why do something once when you can do it twice? There's an oldie, but not as old as others, but not as new as others. Okay, so we're almost there. What is it we're going to do today? Well, I will tell you in just a moment. I'm just gathering up an original tape from Commodore to test the PET. Anyway, I'm putting all this stuff back. Into the sacred service reference guide, which I'm sure will be more helpful as I continue to tinker on these relics of the past. I do believe... well, I can sit there. Okay. So. I need to turn on some power. This over for a second and turn it on so we can see it comes up. Yep, it comes up. And I have not cleaned the keyboard yet, but it does seem to be much better. Here are my broken glasses. It's funny, I have lots of screwdrivers around, but I don't think anything that will fit this. So, but the screw is still there. I'll set that up there. Now, here we have many bits and pieces of things, but still things that cannot get lost. For the pet experiments. But that is not... Well, I suppose, yes. These sockets can just stay. You know, it's a good thing to start something and sort of finish it. Not that I would know so well. Not that I would. Oh look, there's something I found recently. A disk storage case. Yes, with the key. Now, do I have any disks in it? Not yet. But I will. Maybe that can sit on that monitor. So what I have in front of me here are things I must be very careful with. They are chips from the pet here. Look, here's an original cassette drive that is not working. I believe it's a belt, but I haven't had it open yet. And here I have some of the original chips from this machine. I will set them on the cassette drive. Now, I have a little room to work here. I do. By the way, yes, that music you hear in the background is indeed a Commodore. Well, it's actually Commodore 128, I think. It's funny, you know, there are different versions of the SID chip, and certain ones seem to be more highly prized than others, and I don't know why. But there must be some differences, otherwise there wouldn't be different versions. So...
That was easy. Thank you.
My. Oh, yeah. I'm just looking and seeing that, oh, yeah, that pet is going to be a distraction. The screen is rolling. So, turn it off. Never knew the case of a pet makes a fine drum. So, I'm going to do something. Yes, I am. I was in the basement. And I was looking for a box or packing stuff for the Silver Label Commodore 64 that went to Italy. By the way, it has arrived. And all is well and good. Anyway, so I found this box and I thought, oh great, a box. And I picked it up. And guess what? It has stuff in it. Now, what's in it? I don't know. This is the Commodore 64 is an easy to use microcomputer suited for business, home, and education. This package includes the Commodore 64 keyboard, power transformer, easy to use manual, the basic programming language, plus a connector for TV if you wish to attach the Commodore 64 to your standard black and white or color television set. Isn't that special? Anyway, but what's in here? I don't know. But I guess we'll find out first. The sacred sleeve. And yet, so, what's in here? I don't know. As I said, it could be a Commodore 64. It could be who knows what. I don't remember exactly when I got this, but in a moment, the truth will be known. Is a Commodore 64. And oh, while not perfect, it does have some styrofoam pieces used to protect it during shipping. Oh, they are tight. I can see already that this machine has been used. It actually looks a little dirty, but you know, aren't we all? Certainly nothing terribly remarkable with the serial number. Looks like it's in the 5 million range. But it looks okay. But now, in the little box here, we have a power supply. No books, no manuals. Just the Commodore 64. But the Commodore 64 is a good thing. It's funny, the sticker is not on the place that the sticker is traditionally. It's also kind of bigger. Anyway, it looks intact. It does. power supply a try. Yep. On this machine. I'm just looking. There should be a cord here. There's the machine. And there. To go to the video monitor, but I do not see the video monitor has power. So around we go, somewhere over here. So, we now have power. It is not plugged in yet. Somehow, I have a feeling that there will be trouble here. Why? I don't know. This has been sitting around for a long time. Who knows for how long? Does it work? Who knows? We're about to find out. We apply power. So far, we see nothing on the screen. And so far, we see nothing on the screen. Not surprising. These things have been around a while. Now, somewhere here, but I don't see it. I should have the dead test. Funny, it does all the flickery things that it should, but it does nothing. Well, here's Jumpman Jr. Let's stick that in there for a second. See if anything happens. Well, one thing though I see, looking at the box here, that this is indeed the original box from this machine that is dead. Oh, well. But you know, the box these days can be highly prized, and this one is in pretty fine shape. Oh dear. Well, I'm not going to open this up now. I am kind of irked in that I do not see the dead test cartridge here. Perhaps I need to go back and look at some video. See where I might have put it. It's not very big. But I can't imagine I have misplaced it. Mind you, the dead test cartridge heart, generally speaking, found from the dead test cartridge is that if a machine is dead and this is a thing that is supposed to wake it up, say, oh, this is what's wrong. It generally doesn't. So, I have found it. And I will turn it on. And I suspect I will see nothing. Indeed, I see nothing. Oh dear, 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 dear. Well, there are worse things. Have a Commodore 64 with an original box. We're in the serial number in the 5 million range. So, well, I don't think I'm going to dig into this right now. I do not. I think it was quite good findings. It's funny, even though this one says, of course, and it says proudly somewhere in here, made in the USA, it's obviously the sleeve was made for Canada. Behold, it has the Canadian Olympic symbol, and it makes reference to Commodore at 3370 Pharmacy Avenue, Agent Court, Ontario. I wonder what's there now. I wonder. Well, I guess I can keep turning this on and seeing nothing, which is not exciting. Anyway, at some point soon, I'm hoping to get back in the pet game and see what I can see. These two fine machines. I would really like to hopefully revive one of them completely. But we'll see. Anyway, well, the light on the Commodore 64 comes on. That is encouraging. But that's about it. So, I've been corresponding with a fellow. I think he's in Holland. He's looking for an original box. But I'm not sure if this fits the bill. It is the box, which is very plain, on the sleeve, which is very colorful. I will have to investigate. Well, it's the middle of the night here, so maybe it's time to go back to sleep. I had high hopes that this would work. Oh well. Until we meet again.